Well, the drought in the Western Cape is arguably one of the most talked about stories of 2017. In 2016, it was labelled the worst in 70 years, but this year it escalated to the worst in over a century. Both the province and the city of Cape Town have been declared disaster areas. Authorities embarked on a massive safe water information drive, and a number of projects are underway to utilise ground sources.
In February, reality hit home. The mother city may run out of water. Level 3B restrictions were implemented in Cape Town. Capetonians were asked to limit usage. 29 of 35 municipal pools were closed during weekdays. Water usage stood at 837 million litres per day, far exceeding the 700 million litres target. A month later, the city was declared a disaster area. More severe restrictions were imposed and infrastructure programs brought forward.
But it can also help us to free up more resources, to employ more teams that can help us with water leakages, repair old infrastructure. It will also assist us to look how we can use wastewater, treat that water so that we can become drinkable again or pump it back into our dams.
As autumn approached, religious leaders prayed for divine intervention.
We are the custodians, and not as we sometimes think that we own and we can do what we want, but we are actually here to take care of and of the blessings that we are receiving.
Entering its third year, the drought was hitting farmers hard. Agriculture is the backbone of the Western Cape economy. Werner Dirks had to change tact. He adopted a new business plan, planted more crops, and changed his sheep breed.
We don't have a surety to go and lend some money. We know it's hard for the banks, but I think they have to change a few stuff to help upcoming farmers so that they can have a surety just to keep going.
In farming areas, the focus shifted to canals and water catchment systems ahead of the expected winter rains. But the rains never came. Dam levels would remain low, and by May, the province was declared a disaster area.
We need to do things very quickly now, such as drill boreholes, such as get expertise to tell us where best we should drill those boreholes without depleting the underground water resources. We need to do environmental impact assessments in order to tap into the Table Mountain aquifer without damaging the water resources. So there are a lot of things we need to do reasonably quickly, and we need to shortcut the otherwise very lengthy processes we would have to go through.
By the end of May, the agriculture sector declined by around 5%. The wine industry produced the lowest stock in 3 years. By June, there was still no sufficient rain. The city implemented level 4 restrictions. A massive winter storm hit the province, but despite gale force winds, high swells and snow, very little rain fell. The crisis called for innovative water-saving measures. A number of schools installed smart metering technology to drop consumption by several kiloliters per day. Water-intensive businesses were forced to make adjustments. This car wash spent 100,000 rand on a recycling and filtration system.
On average, we're using about between 6, maximum 10 litres of water per car, which is not much. But we're trying to recycle as much as possible so that we can do our part as far as water conservation is concerned.
Livestock farmers were forced to reduce numbers and feed herds out of their pockets.
At this stage, I've already sold 25% of my potential lambing and calving, which is not completed yet, but they already have been sold just to pay for the food that I've consumed already.
Avanant's story is one of many across the barren province.
This country's need for a national water plan is long overdue, and unfortunately, the Department of Water and Sanitation is not coming to light with a water plan because they are the custodians.
The rain that eventually fell only increased dam levels by 8%. The city started to clamp down on excessive users. The daily target was now 500 million litres of water per day, down from 700. Residents were increasingly worried.
I think that they could have definitely implemented 4B water restrictions earlier. I'm not hopeful that we're going to be able to get to the summer season with enough water in our dams to be able to sustain ourselves through summer until the next season.
They see a little bit of rain that comes down. They think that will secure us, but it won't, because we need more, and we need more education around water restrictions and all of those things.
Towards the end of August, government gave 75 million rand in drought relief, especially to assist the agriculture sector. In September, level 5 restrictions were announced. Consumption-reducing devices were installed at high-user businesses and households. At the same time, nuclear power plant Kuberg announced plans to reduce its consumption.
We want to first install the temporary desalination plant. That would be done by the end of this year, so that will be up and running. And then the permanent one will take, installation will take place around about March next year.
By October, the city warned that it could run out of water by March 2018. Government said 550 million rand had been set aside for augmentation programs and admitted it needed to be better prepared in future.
We are already working together with the city on, working together with the provincial government on, in line with the intention to have a national water and sanitation master plan for South Africa.
In mid-November, day zero was pushed back by more than a month. The city praised residents for nearly halving consumption since January 2016. But it demonstrated how water collection points would work should taps run dry. Municipal supply will be cut if dam levels were to drop below 13.5%.
The new normal in Cape Town is that we will be in a permanent drought, and we will have to begin to live like that and get used to that water will never ever be in abundance again, and we must save water at all times.
7 water augmentation supply projects were underway and 12 more in the advanced stages of planning. Test boreholes were drilled in the Table Mountain Group aquifer at Steenbras Dam. The initial yield from the aquifer project should add 10 million litres of water per day. The Table Mountain Group aquifer is scattered over a wide area and was formed millions of years ago.
It's a very unique natural system. And it allows us to drill in very fractured and faulted zones where we can get groundwater. And it does recharge at a relatively rapid rate, some areas. So it's a good renewable resource that can be used if it's used properly and sustainably, which is what the intent is for this project.
At the beginning of December, a proposed drought levy was announced. The aim is to raise 1 billion rand for vital water projects.
So if, for instance, your property is the value of 800,000, we'll ask you to pay an extra 45 rand. If your property is 1 million, we'll ask you to pay an extra 60 rand.
But the proposal was met by resistance.
Residents are being punished. And we were saying as ANC, if it has to go to a push, they must target the wealthy people, starting from properties 1 million rand and above.
I'm a pensioner. So if I have to pay levy and I have to pay whatever I eat and whatever, what do you think, what will I have over?
I'm not very happy about it, and I hope it never ever takes off.
This month, the impact of the drought came full circle, forcing the country to import as much as 60% of its wheat demand. This is 10% more than the usual quantity. The provincial harvest was down by more than 40%.
We are pleading to the credit suppliers that they must take cognizance of what's happening, especially we've got to save the rural areas and see how we can keep these people ticking. Hopefully next year is a better year.
But with no guarantee of enough water after the next rainfall season, the future seems uncertain. One thing is clear, things can never be as they were before. Level 6 water restrictions will be implemented in early January. Mariska Buerta, SABC News,